A few of those passing high clouds still showing up on the satellite image. Radar, though, is free and clear of any precipitation. No big storm system heading in our direction. And we'll keep a good deal of bright skies, but you see on the map here from time to time some passing clouds that are thicker as you head towards the Kentucky and Tennessee border. Storm system going on in the south. You saw Bagatcha Band's report on that. Southwestern portions of the United States, some higher elevation snow, lower elevation rain. That's beneficial, but may still put some snowflakes in around the Las Vegas area. Mountains in Arizona could get 1 to 2 feet. Winter storm warnings are posted there. That storm system will be moving out over the next couple of days, and by the time we head Friday into the weekend, we'll see our own chances of what will mainly be rain, but Friday morning, enough cold air in place that we could see a brief bout of some freezing rain or sleet across the area. Not anticipating any major winter storm problems here, but nonetheless, something to look out for. Look at the cold air, 13 Denver, Fargo 15. At least they've rebounded a little bit from sub-zero temperatures earlier this morning, and only about 6 degrees warmer than this morning in Chicago, which right now is the coldest on the map, at 10 above zero. Indy just 18, 25, and the metro still sub-freezing in Nashville, so that cold air firmly in place across the region. And as we head through this evening and ringing in the new year tonight, maybe a passing cloud or two, but otherwise fair skies and cold, as temperatures will only struggle to highs today in the upper 20s and low 30s. They'll quickly fall back through the 20s tonight, so make sure you're bundled up for your celebrations. Tomorrow morning, looking cold to start the day. More clouds funnel in during the afternoon and evening as well. Skies will eventually turn cloudy Thursday night into Friday morning. And from those clouds, some patchy drizzle, maybe even a sleet pellet or two. I think that precipitation will be very light. You see, it doesn't take a large portion of the map, but down towards the southern parts of the viewing area, again, temperatures could be 32 or a little below, so we may have to watch some bridges and overpasses Friday morning. By Friday afternoon, temperatures go above freezing, and any precipitation that falls from there on through the weekend will be just plain old rain. But for today, bundle up. High temperatures just 31 degrees. For your evening plans and celebrations, temperatures will quickly be falling through the 20s. And we'll ring in the new year at a chilly 25 degrees. 7-day forecast has lows down to 22 tonight, highs only in the upper 30s tomorrow and Friday. Again, Friday morning we'll watch closely, but it doesn't look to be a big deal for any freezing rain or sleet. And then it just turns to a soaking rain for the weekend. Maybe a few wet snowflakes on Sunday as temperatures plummet. Good news about weekend temperatures, Karen, is that we hit 57 on Saturday. We won't be able to enjoy it with the rain, but maybe we'll give the furnace in the house a little bit of a break. But we'll quickly fall into the 30s Sunday, and it looks like a frigid week ahead. By Wednesday next week, highs will only be in the 20s with lows in the teens again. January is here.
Cold.
Yes.
But no snow to start off.
That's right. It doesn't look like anything in terms of any big winter weather threats heading our way. So that's also some good news.
Yes, most definitely. All right. Thank you, Matt.